Yeah, Popeyes. I know them chairs anyway, anywhere. Well, I think it's Popeyes. Okay. Yolanda is pretty. What happens if I press the X? Do I get to pick more than one? Or, well, not more than one, but do I get, like, the choices? Oh. Are we doing it anyway? We don't have a choice. We don't have a choice. Like how we don't have a choice. Ooh, I'm getting chills. Girl. Oh. Danny! Drugs, misogynoir, conspiracy theories. That's the content warning, you guys. In the past few months, you've gotten better understanding of life, of how life has been treating you. The mothers of your children have left you alone for the most part, at least since you started taking your kids to school and picking them up whenever they asked. You made an effort to get closer with your kids outside of the basic childish shit you found yourself indulging in. Side note, why the fuck does your daughter like Peppa Pig so much? I had to think for a second, because Peppa Pig's not that bitch. You know who that bitch is? Miss Olivia. Miss motherfucking Olivia. Miss motherfucking Olivia. Olivia! Olivia! Yeah, that's that bitch. That's that girl. Anyway. Something about those eyes haunts you and find yourself looking away whenever she puts it on. But the one thing you still find troubling is the trajectory of your track rap career. You have a decent following on Bound and people are talking about your music locally. Maybe because you've had... You have sort of shifted from serious rap to comedy rap, doing stuff to appeal to the big buck crowd you begrudgingly accepted. Who knew it'd be so easy to get teens to do shitty dances to your fucked up music? Rapping offbeat to a shit beat appears to be the pinnacle of music these days, and as much as you hate to admit it, it's getting you a lot more attention than the things you put your heart and soul into. With this stuff, it takes you maybe an hour tops to create a shit beat with some samples, and the rapping just comes naturally. Maybe you were just meant for the comedy rap. Fuck. You ignore that feeling of failure for the time being. You have things to do and a backpack full of CDs slung over your shoulder. One of the homies told you about this place on the Upper East Side of the city, not too far from your place, but you still took the trip and drove instead of calling a rideshare. Who knows what kind of woman you can pull at an open mic. Women gravitate towards you and typically stay for a couple of weeks until they realize how inconsistent you are when it comes to maintaining relationships. Or until one of your baby mamas, probably Tara, finds out you're talking to another woman and tries to sabotage you because she's an evil woman who only wants to see a black man lose. I hope Tara's not white. Well, is she white? Maybe if you had gotten a, I can't pronounce that, I'm sorry, Ghanaian, sorry, anyway, when pregnant your mother wouldn't see you as such a disappointment, your siblings would make fun of you every chance they give, you've dealt with enough favoritism growing up, with how much lighter your skin is compared to your siblings, being the only one to get the light skin gene from your great-grandfather on your mom's side. Your parents expected so much from you, but you've done nothing but disappoint. Damn, this is depressing as hell. A light-skinned disappointment. I'm sorry, Buki. Yet Alice was different. She never saw your flaws. She was your first love, the woman you wish your mother approved of. They never got along. You've known Alice since you were in high school, but didn't actually start talking to her until you both graduated. Becoming local rappers brought you both closer, and soon you fell in love with her, but the love never felt mutual, no matter how much she tried to convince you that it was. You knew her love wasn't for people, but for her craft, and it showed more when you got her pregnant, and she didn't seem to care about the child you both had. Yikes. You can't think about that right now. You're already an hour late to this open mic, and if you sit in your car any longer, someone might call the cops. You enter the salon? Yeah, this is a hair salon, but instead of the usual chairs and mirrors, it's rows and rows of folded chairs. The ceiling is littered with spotlights, bright red neon lights shaped like roses hug the ceiling. You'll come here with your daughter one day, or you should at least, she's been asking for braids for a while. Find yourself lingering at the doorway, not wanting to disturb the person on stage reciting a slam poem, and not a very good one, in your attempt to find a seat, so you wait, listening for a moment before realizing you ultimately are not that interested. The back on your shoulder is slipping. You move your shoulder to adjust it. You scan the area in front of you, and just like from behind, you can already tell you've run into a few familiar faces in here. People you want to talk to? Fuck no. But you know they might try to talk to you if you try to perform, even though you may be a little late for that. Hey, who the fuck knows what will happen? You didn't realize how long you were lingering near the door until you hear the soft voice of someone speaking right above the whisper. You nearly jump, not expecting anyone to pay much attention to you. You look down in the direction the voice came from. Fuck. 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 Hey, you look new here. You want to perform or just checking out the scene? She caught you by surprise, and you find yourself staring a little more than you would like to admit. Starstruck or heart eyes, you really can't decide what emotion you want to portray or you think you're portraying. What the entire fuck is wrong with you? The man who can sling any hoe he wants is suddenly starstruck in front of a woman, a really beautiful woman. God damn it. Oh shit, no, I mean... maybe. I haven't thought that far ahead yet. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. Okay. Ooh, get myself together. My homie told me to come here and check out the scene. Get my clout up and pass out some tapes. You're a rapper? I feel like there's a right answer to this, but I'ma say kinda. I mean, yeah, I am, cause like he doesn't, I mean, I don't know, I'ma say I'm a musician. Oh, what instrument do you play? Yeah, said you were a musician. You do know that musician means anyone who makes music, right? She rolls her eyes at you, flat out rolls her eyes at you. It's like she wants you to see how annoyed she is by this conversation. Damn, I fumbled. My bad. I'm aware, but people don't really use it like that anymore. Or at least most of the people here. Okay, now you just feel like an asshole. Hopefully that doesn't put her off too much. Shit. My bad, nah, I just rap and produce beats. Reaching to your bag, offering her a tape, one of your nicer ones, a sleek case with your name and number, even a heart at the end of it. This one is always safe for the ladies. The look she gives you is typical. You're the only one in the city actively handing out mixtapes, and the majority of people don't even have working CD players in their cars anymore. Always considered switching to primarily digital media, but the concept of being unique is what appealed to you. You always stood out no matter what you did. And until you find another way to be unique, you'll keep this going. Got a name? Yolanda. You sure giving out CDs is the best form of advertising? You know, most people don't even have a CD player anymore. What about BoundCloud? I've been thinking about it. Something about keeping it physical makes it more authentic, you know? What if the white man decides to close the internet and everything we kept on and is gone? At least I still got my music in physical form. You read your fair share of theories about how the internet is controlled by a select few companies who can decide to shut it down whenever they want, and the thought of that is daunting at times. Losing all of your progress, your fans, and haters is scary enough to keep you awake at night. Fine, I'll take you up on that, but you can't go around blaming the white man for everything. Are you one of those white people aren't that bad types? You watch as she ponders the question. You're almost tempted to walk away from this entirely, but then you remember she offered to let you perform and is probably one of the people in charge here. With the way people talk in the city, you'd rather not have your reputation ruined over this. What? No. I mean, not really. A lot of them come here and are pretty cool, but I'm always wary, you know? She's one of those. Fine. You can't get mad that she doesn't follow your philosophy. Not many people have the IQ to understand it.
Okay.
Like, you kind of showing your ass a little bit, but he's their own, I guess. Yeah, I get that. Sometimes you think everything is going great and then bam. They can't take you home because their parents don't like us. I'm sorry that happened to you. That's really shitty. I've had my fair share of my Korean grandmother being like that until I have to remind her that I'm black. A Korean grandmother let out a small laugh at that, reaching a hand up to rub the back of your neck. You still have a little more in common with this woman than you thought you would. Still, you're treading carefully with the words you say. You can't give her all of you yet. My mom is the same way, always wanting me to bring home some Ghana woman. She still hates my baby mamas, but treats my kids like her own. They're with her right now. I'm not Ghana, but I'm French and Korean. The colonizer and the colonized. I thought he was just gonna ha 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 ki ki ki, like she's ha ha ki ki ki. But why would he say that? Why would you say that? Why would you say that? Why would you say that? Oh
my god. Oh my god, this is so bad.
This is so bad.
Oh no.
I'm gonna speed through this. I'm sorry. You are really showing your ass right now, Malik. I don't fuck men who aren't creatives. But you did pass me a tape. Okay, so it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad. Like she didn't hate the comment. Thank God. Thank God, cause I was. Ugh. Anyway, you did pass me a tape and wait. Is she considering fucking you too? Maybe after I give it a listen.
We in there. We fucking in there.
You give yourself a point for that one, but you have been trying to tone down the misogyny lately. Got a CD player in here? Shit, we can always go to my car and pop it in. Ditch this joint. I'm not ditching anything. But I will head out to listen to this tape. Just two songs. Other people still have to perform, you know. Okay, maybe you should bring out the scoreboard for this one. You always like to log your accomplishments, and so far, you've had to. There's dead ass a scoreboard. That's crazy. Lead her to the direction of your car. After passing out a few tapes to people in the back row, she didn't comment on it, so she's probably seen it before. Your car is cleanish, keep shit off the floor, but you're a father of two young kids, and with that comes spills, pores, and the occasional food stain, but you never know who you might pull. Your mother always told you women didn't like a messy man. You use your remote to unlock the door. Thank God it worked this time. Walking a few steps ahead to open the door for her. Welcome to Casa de Malik. You live in your car? Wait, no. Shit. Your feet are flushing up. This is stupid. You never let women see this part of you until you hit the bedroom. What is it about this woman who allows you to be so vulnerable despite just meeting her? Alright, she's getting a point for that. Malik 1, Yolanda 1. Is she a witch? You heard those were real. Your African mother always told you to stay away from them. Yeah. She's a witch. Absolutely. Absolutely. Look at that chicken. The chicken is smiling with her. That is her familiar. Okay? Trust me, I know these things. What do you think? Don't sugarcoat shit for me. You look like a child about to receive some ice cream. As you turn to look at her, she doesn't seem... Nigga, this was awful. Yo, I'm fucking crying. Yo, she said this shit was ass, my nigga. Kill your producer. Bruh, that's fucking crazy. That nigga, this was awful. Yeah, you're not getting ass, bro. You're not getting any type of hookah. You're not getting any type of hookah. Shit was buns. Dog, definitely kill your producer because this shit is ass. Oh my gosh. Ouch. You've heard a lot of negative thoughts about your music, but it felt like she got your ass after that one. She probably hears a lot of music from the performers and you didn't live up to her high standards. But not everyone can be a lover. You shrug it off as you look towards the car parked in front of yours. You take a deep breath, swallowing that pride, Malik. Nobody wants to see that. Fine, fair. Not everyone has to like my style. It isn't about your style. I know what you're going for. It's just you need to find the meat to match. I've heard a lot of rappers. I'm here every Friday. Fuck, I have to get back. You're not given the chance to reply before she's leaving your car and walking back towards the shop. You jog to meet up with her, stepping ahead of her to open the door. You're smooth with it as you lean down to whisper in her ear, the nervousness of earlier dispersing into the evening sky. And your confidence is... Hey, you gotta use it to your advantage sometimes. I can't stand light-skinned niggas. I really truly cannot. I'm not done with you.
What? What you mean? Back up. Back up. You're doing a little bit too much right now.
A little bit too much right now. Okay.
Boo.
That was awful. To be fair, it's been a couple of months since you tried to spit game. You've been focusing on being somewhat better. On being a somewhat better father. Dating with two kids is not ideal. She looks so flushed. Flustered.
I'm flustered too, nigga. Fuck.
You have to give yourself a point for that dub. Malik 2, Yolanda 1.
Yeah, I'm not gonna hold you. If I'm walking away from somebody and they grab my shoulder and be like, I'm not done with you. I'm like, what you mean? What you mean you're not done with me? What? What's going on?
Anyway. Well, now you really can't leave. Already hooked her in, might as well keep reeling. You take a seat in the back and pull out your phone, scrolling social media to pass time until this thing is over. You watch her from the corner of your eye. She seems to run this place and she smiles a lot. Huh? You're avoiding thinking about it. You definitely didn't spend the entire past hour thinking about why you liked her smile so much. The lights cut back on and everyone...
If I don't come.
can't be a good guy? Wow. What a world to live in. Yeah. That gets a laugh out of you. Being unironic, and so, isn't that funny? She even rolls her eyes at you. Ouch. Bring your hand up to your chest. Feet of the fence. Fine. Can you put this by the other mic? Sure thing. Say princess, but it got her too worked up again, and honestly, that's another point for you. Damn, Malik, you're kind of scoring right now. You take your time as you try to properly organize the mic stands. You're trying to make a good impression, or that might just be the perfectionist in you. You really can't tell at this point. You know, you don't have to. I know. I just wanted to make a good first impression. You didn't have to say that, but I guess you made up your mind. First impression. You like what you saw today? You let out a laugh, abandoning your task before striding towards her. Get a bit closer than a stranger would be, leaning your hand against the beam behind her as you look down at her. You're going to have to do better if you want anything to do with me. Ouch. For a woman this calm, she's feisty. You like that in a woman, someone who can talk back. Too many women allow you to get away with your bullshit instead of calling you out, and that's boring. I hate when niggas do this. Why is it up to the woman or the other person to call you out on your bullshit when you know you bullshitting? Come on. Get that shit together, bro. Like creating chaos, you know you're getting when you're... Fuck, I can't read! Oh my gosh! You like creating chaos when you know you're going to get punished for it. Punished probably isn't the right word to use there. Fine. Tell everyone to go home. I'll clean this place myself. What? You think cleaning is going to win me over? Man. Realize you don't actually want to do that shit. Okay. Let's backpedal a little. Oh, I was kidding. I wouldn't do that. Uh-huh. Unless you want me to. You need to stop talking. Fuck. Quick. How do you get out of this? Wait, that's easy. Just look like you're joking. Smirk. And once you notice you're still standing over her, you take a step back to her room. Give her... Fuck. Fuck. Come on. Read. Thank God you showered and brushed your teeth before this. If you really want some pussy, you're gonna have to try a lot better than that. Alright, yeah. You were not expecting that one at all. She really fucking got you there. You didn't expect to have to try so hard tonight. Guess you have to bust out the big ones then. Sheesh, fine. What do you want? Don't you have the rest of the mixtape to show me? Perk up, but you can't show your excitement. It'll scare her away. You haven't had much luck being vulnerable with women. Wait, didn't you say it was awful? Now, is she trying to get in your drawers? Man, women these days are too confident. Not that you have anything against a confident woman. You just don't need a hard-on in public, especially in front of a woman you just met. I knew this game was gonna be like, kind of like, I think it's like rated M, like that, but I didn't, I don't know what I was expecting. I wonder if she's into doming. Yeah, but I still have to listen to the whole thing. Fuck yes. Yes. God, fuck yes. You won. You finally won. And there you were, thinking this was going to be a bust. Again, you calm yourself down. She can step away from this at any moment, and the thought of that is a little scary. Unless the women you fuck with are wrapped around your finger. But she's acting like she couldn't care less. Honestly, it's hurting your ego, but you ignore it for the time being as you reach into your bag to grab your keys. And let's go. You don't get close to her this time, dangling your keys above her head instead of realizing she's not as sure as you thought she was. You can just lean down and don't do it. Back up. Damn, that's a lot of dots. What we doing? Oh, I thought we was gonna get a little singing. So, how do you like it? Do you smoke? What? You're in love. You're literally in love. You haven't had a girl impress you like this in years. You're staring, and you know you're staring, but fuck. Is that all it takes? Some fucking weed. I'm kidding. I'm joking. Okay, Malik. Come on. You can't sit here with your mouth hanging open like a fish. Close it and grin instead, sitting back before you speak. Come on. Not all rappers smoke. I know. But you do. How do you know? She reaches in between your seats and pulls out a Honey Bunch wrapper you probably forgot to throw out. Fuck. Touché. You reach into your pocket to pull out a lighter, one of your specialty ones that you remove the safety off of. Fiddling with it with your hands, you glance at her from the corner of your eyes, realizing how close she is with the blunt between her lips. Oh, we're kissing. Kissing. Well, I'll be damned. Well, wanna know what happens next? Find out next time on Malik's Run in part 2, technically. Because this was, actually no, 1.2. Because we're still in the first part. I don't know. But anyway, I'll see you guys.